时间。
It's already the scheduled time, and we formed a quorum. Let's get started. Thank you, Director of Audit. Secretary, welcome. And let us welcome a representative from the ELB as well. Because ELB is not a member of, they are not a public officer, so the legal advisor would like to advise them on their position. Thank you. Apart from officers appointed to attend our meetings, other persons attending a LegCo meeting will not enjoy the powers and privileges under the LegCo Powers and Privileges Ordinance. Thank you. We have to discuss Chapter 6, or rather, Chapter 3 of Director of Audit Report Number 74, Employees Retraining Board. This is a bit different from ordinary public hearings, Secretary. Today, we only have half an hour for this chapter, i.e. Chapter 3 of Report Number 74, because you've already accepted all the recommendations for improvement from the Director of Audit. So this morning, we just want to give you an opportunity to tell us how you are going to improve and carry out the recommendations by the Director of Audit. And if we have questions, we will take the opportunity to put them to you. Mr. Xiu Ka Fai is responsible for this chapter. I believe the Secretary has some opening remarks. Please be succinct. Thank you. I'm grateful to the Audit Commission for doing this value for money on the Employees Retraining Board. The recommendations are very valuable. I understand that ELB has by and large accepted all the recommendations and formulated measures to implement them. The Labour Welfare Bureau will continue to provide the necessary support and to ensure the recommendations can be implemented. The report commented on the LWB's supervision of ELB and have some recommendations for us. We'll follow up with the ELB, and the LWB has assisted ELB to amend the relevant subsidiary legislation. So the statutory monthly allowance for retraining will be increased from $4,800 to $5,800, up 45%. In view of the current economic situation, ELB has enhanced the support for relevant staff. In last October, a special love upgrade scheme was launched to help employees affected by the economic downturn. By receiving retraining, they can upgrade their value and join the workforce again. ELB plans to start a new special scheme in July, and the monthly allowance, as I said, the ceiling is now $5,800. I'm happy to take questions and suggestions from members. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Law. Mr. Xiu, being the lead member, you can start. In relation to Chapter 3 of Report Number 7 of Director of Audit on ERB, now we have some issues about the governance of ERB. I understand that some board members well, 18.5% of them declared their interest after the due date. So can you comment on this? Executive Director of ERB. Thank you. There is a two-tier declaration of interest system. And there is an annual declaration. And each time before a board or committee meeting, the chairman or convener at the start of a meeting will remind members anew if there is any item on the agenda where there may be a possible conflict of interest. Members are invited to declare, and then a decision will be made as to whether the member should leave or stay. We agree that in the past few years, individual members were perhaps out of town, and they returned the declaration of interest late. So in this legislative year, starting from April onward, we've been reminding our members continuously, and all members have returned their declaration of interests to us within a month, and we'll continue to monitor this. Thank you. My second question is in assisting young people aged between 15 and 29, the number of trainees were on the low side, Have you ever reviewed the reasons for that? Of course, the chief executive can, executive director can supplement, but as we all know, for Hong Kong people in this age cohort, there's been a drop of 30% in this sector of the population in the past 50 years, and then this would affect the enrollment rate of this age group in our courses. Any supplement from the executive director? As the secretary said, we will enhance the programs for young people. In particular, in December last year, we set up a task force for youth training. We've invited NGOs serving our youth and also employers that employ young people to tell us what is the most needed short-term training for this age group. The task force gave us a number of recommendations which are already implemented. For instance, we have a training letter. So after completing courses for KOF1, they can proceed to KOF2. For instance, there is a program on comics. And if they've completed, they can proceed to computer publishing. Given that this is the digital age, we've enhanced the digital literacy of our trainees. In different programs, we've included elements such as programming and 5G so that they can become generic skills of young people. We'll also develop programs that suit the interests of our young people. For instance, comprehensive stage performance training course, and there will be different professional certificates added so that they have more options when they want to try different industries. We have a basic training for construction safety, first aid training certificate, etc. This year, we will conduct a survey on the interests of our young people on retraining. Can you please tell us because in the report, there are many points you've already accepted. In particular, your staff turnover seems to be on the high side. So, how are you going to address the recommendation by the Director of Audit so that you can do better in this aspect? We give you the opportunity today. We would like to hear more from you, what measures you have to improve your performance so that you can really fulfill the objectives for your establishment. Thank you. We agree that in the past 3 years, our staff turnover has been in a range of 5 to 10%, and that is rather high. We have adopted a multi-pronged approach to enhance recruitment and retention and a sense of belonging on the part of our staff. We have also enhanced internal team spirit training, hoping that our staff can see a career future in ELB so as to reduce staff turnover. We've also done a market survey to see whether our remuneration package is out of tune with the market. We will work very closely with the Labour and Welfare Bureau, hoping that in terms of resources, training, and by means of enhancing team spirit, we can lower the turnover rate. And also your financial situation. How are you going to improve your financial situation? Your annual deficit is rising year on year. So, in terms of your staff morale, staff turnover, and your financial situation, they are not very satisfactory. So you've accepted all the recommendations by the Director of Audit. You have to tell us how you're going to improve. I understand that the Secretary for Labour and Welfare will assist you, but at least there must be some suggestions from ELB. Thank you. Last year, our deficit was about $400 million. That is not really a deficit, because the purpose of ELB is to provide training programs that suit market needs to add value to our workforce and to boost productivity. We have got a $14 billion seed money from the government. It will yield interest for us, and we will put them in higher interest yielding products. And we will, of course, spend money where it is needed, and we will manage our finances very carefully. And if we need resources in any way, we will hope that the Secretary can help us to secure support from LegCo. For instance, we have the special love upgrade scheme and also retraining programs, and we have another $2.5 billion from the Council to do that.
We will continue to do that. So we would also like to give our colleagues a long-term vision to let them see that the ERB has sound finances and they can have good prospects working in the organization, that, so that they are more willing to stay with us. Another thing, concerning your training courses, they seem not to be advancing with the times. On the one hand, the staff turnover rate is high, your financial position is not that sound, and the KPIs, key performance indicators, are not very desirable either. So that's why we've invited you to come here today, so that you can tell the community how you are going to attract more young people to join your courses, so that Hong Kong's productivity can be boosted We have high unemployment rate now. So what are you going to do in terms of boosting your training programs? If yes, what are your proposals? We need to write a report, and we will follow up duly. Thank you. Thank you, Chairman. I'd like to thank the Chairman for giving me the opportunity to clarify here. Yes, the Audit Commission has seen that in the past few years for individual programs, the KPIs might not be met. But let me clarify that we have four KPIs, including utilization rate of the courses, attendance rate of trainees, graduation rate, and also placement rate. Now, in the past 5 years, overall, these targets have been met, and some have even been surpassed. But then for 5% of the classes, because, say, for individual reasons of the participants, then the relevant targets are not met. But every time when the target is not met, we would be talking to the relevant training body to see the reasons why, because they are under pressure as well. Because every time if we allocate places to training bodies, we'll look at whether the targets have been met. If these are not met, then we will not allocate that many places to them. So we will work together with them to improve the situation. So overall, the four KPIs have been met. We will not rest on our laurels. We will continue to improve. Chairman referred to programs for young people. We are looking at that also. In the past few years, the focus of ERB is very much on middle-aged people and people about to retire. We would like to maximize or boost their productivity. But after the social incidents last year, we've shifted our focus more to young people and adolescents. Maybe young people would not pursue further studies. They would like to join some training courses. And also ERPB would like to play a role in properly train them after they leave school and before they actually start working in the community. We will try to come up with more job types that match them. Of course, the babysitters and health workers might not be that suitable for young people. We will develop more courses in relation to, say, sports and recreation, for example, assistant coach programs or programs on pet care, and also mobile app programming, etc. So these are the job types that we're looking at. And these are jobs very much needed in the market. So we'll be looking at those courses. And usually in the past, the programs for young people last for around half a year. Now, we would be launching more short-term courses. Some young people would not like to, say, study for 6 months. Maybe just they would like to just study for 2 to 3 months. So we will offer such courses to train up young people. So apart from boosting the skills, we would also be offering courses on conduct and attitudes, how they should interact with their employers, what kind of moral or ethical standards that they should abide by, etc. So these are the programs that we are thinking about as an effort to improve our programs. Like I said, we would like to develop some career ladder for them as well. After they've taken taught courses from ERB, maybe they would like to articulate to courses in, say, the VTC and Open University. So we're also working on that as well. We also like to organize more professional courses. Say, for example, for building, there will be security guards employed. So we'd like to offer professional courses in that regard so that young people can really develop a profession in that area. Mr. Xu, is it my turn to ask a question? Well, this meeting is different from other meetings in a sense. Basically, we would just like to hear from them on how they would improve their work. And Mr. Lam, it's okay for you to ask first. I haven't started asking a question yet. So I'll just ask one question, Chairman. Table 13 on page 35 refers to placement tied courses and the relevant placement rate. So that sets out the situation from 2014 to 2019. My question is, it seems that every year the placement rate of some courses is just 0%. For example, 2015-16, there are 161 programs, and then 17 programs have a placement rate of 0%. And in 2018-19, there are 158 programs, and for a zero placement rate, there are 15 programs. So in other words, around the placement, well, they around 10% of the programs come with a zero placement rate. So what kind of what kind of programs are these? How come that the placement rate was only 0%? Especially the economy has been faring quite well in the past few years. How come that nobody on that course got placed in a job? How come that this is the case? Thank you, Mr. Lam. In point 2.46 in page 38, paragraph C, we're talking about a relative placement rate and not the absolute figure. I said just now that the placement rate meets the target, and our target is 70%. In the past few years, the overall placement rate was 93%. So what do you mean by relative placement rate? And that is, they enroll on a program for a particular job or a trade. And if they get placed in that particular job or sector, then it's the relative placement rate. This is for our internal reference and is not used for assessing the effectiveness of our program. Of course, we train them. The most important thing is that they get a job. And we hope that the programs can meet with market needs. For example, in pet care programs, we hope that the graduates can work in a pet shops. But because of the very good economic situation in the past few years in Hong Kong, the graduates have many choices in the market as far when it comes to job placement. So that means that for the particular jobs that they're trained on, their salary may not meet with their expectations, then they may not opt for the jobs. So our aim is that they can get a job within 3 months after their graduation, and then that accounts towards the placement rate. We find, as Mr. Lam pointed out, if a graduate can find a job in the within 1 to 2 years after graduation, but he's not working in that particular job that he's trained on, then we will think about whether that program is really suited to the market. So please draft a report for us so that we can better understand the situation and we can write up our own reports. Hang on. I'm asking him to write a report. I'd like him to address this question. How come that every year 10% of the programs come with a zero placement rate? So can you address that in your report, Mr. Stephen Ho, and then followed by Mr. Xiu, the main questioner today. Stephen, I have two brief questions. The number of young people enrolling in the courses has been on the low side, and there is decreasing number of ethnic minorities admitted to ERB courses. Now, apart from the design of the courses, is it that because there aren't enough publicity channels? For the younger generation, they might not be able to learn about your courses. Maybe the teachers have not promoted your courses, so that's why there has been a decreasing number. So in your report, can you address these concerns and how, and tell us categorically how you are going to improve on the situation? My second question is on part four. In 4.11, you said that there is a smart living scheme and there are 8 operators. For these 8 operators, are they chosen based on the different districts? 3 have not met the targets, and after 2 years, 2 will be suspended, in tendering for the service. And then there is another operator which you have disqualified them. So have you already taken our tender? Are there enough operators in the market for your selection? They haven't been able to meet your targets. Is it the case that you don't have more choices for the operators? So that's why you still have to turn to them. And what about your assessment? It's a 20-20-60 in terms of register and number of vacancies in the register, the number of vacancies fulfilled, and also the placement rate and so on. So have you been successful in your publicity efforts? Actually, I've gone to one of your Yunlong Center in Smart Living Scheme. The people in the district know little about Smart Living Scheme. They rather take on Filipino maids instead of using the scheme's service. Is it the case that you have not done enough publicity among people so that your work has been unsuccessful as a result? So if local people do not want to use Smart Living Scheme, no matter how you're going to improve the scheme, that would be of no use. So can you address these questions in your report to be submitted to us later? Mr. Xu. The secretary referred to the age group of 15 to 29. There has been a decrease in the number of trainees in that age group. And the secretary said that the number of people in that age group has dropped by 30% in the past decade. I think that's a reasonable figure. In your report 2.5, in page 13, the Audit Commission said that there are 2 age groups. One is 15 to 29, and then there is another age group for those aged above 30. It says that of those aged between 15 and 29 and enrolling in ERB courses, the percentage is from 8.4% to 12.2%, but for those above 30, the figures are as high as 89%. So how are we going to interpret these figures? Why is there such a big difference?
Chairman, well, I think it's because the median age of our workforce in Hong Kong has risen. As mentioned by the executive director, we attach more significance to older employees. Now, even for those who are over 50, the ratio among our ERB trainees are over 50. Over 50% of them are over 50. So we have more trainees that are older. That means that ERB should focus its resources on older employees. Now, for youngsters, they have lots of opportunities. They can enroll in VTC and also other institutes. I do understand. Chairman. Two members suggested that they provide written replies because this is different from ordinary hearing. The purpose today is to give you an opportunity to tell us your plan for the future, because the report is about your track record, and then we have to compile a report. We have to tell the council as well as members of the public how you are going to move forward. Even though you have a deficit of $100 million a year, that is fine, because your objective is to provide training to young people, and this is very meaningful. But the question is whether we're getting value for money. So if you have problems in your own corporate governance and in your system, you have to tell us how you're going to improve. As said by Mr. Stephen Ho, you have a problem of acceptability, and you're so your orientation towards ethnic minorities, and whether your training courses can have a higher relevancy, and also the age of your trainees. So I hope you can give us a written reply and give us a suggestion or a plan covering the short, medium, and long-term perspectives. Can that be done? Chairman, this is the first time we have this approach, and perhaps officials are not very accustomed to this. In fact, we want short questions and short answers. You asked him to give us a written reply, but we wanted to take this opportunity to let the public know. I hope, can you give them 2 more minutes so at least there can be something for the press? All right. All right, then what questions do you have so that they can give you an overall reply? Yes, I said young people have other options, and therefore our bill will focus on older employees. In our 74-3-Gen 1, in para 3, on a program for young people, you're providing allowance, a daily allowance of $44, and for the love upgrade scheme, a daily allowance of $223, and the monthly allowance is only $5,800. In fact, in the past, they've only given $30 per hour in allowance. You haven't adjusted the allowance for a long time. Can it be one of the reasons why young people don't want to choose ERB programs? Because $40 is hardly sufficient to buy a lunch box, not to mention traffic costs. Well, the adjustment only took effect last month, and therefore information provided covered the situation before the adjustment. We hope that with this adjustment in allowance, I hope it can be attractive. I will give you 10 minutes. Please tell LegCo and also the public how you will strengthen the ERB. Thank you. We understand some of the concerns raised by the Audit Commission because of the labor market, the changes in the economy, and changes in trade. So we have to keep updating the situation. When the relevancy rate is low, we have to keep reviewing the programs on offer. Now, this is a continuous exercise, because after the review this year, come next year, the situation may have changed already. So we'll continue to improve the situation. Let's see if the executive director has anything to add. Thank you. To answer some of the questions by Mr. Ho, we are going to step up publicity this year. Special love upgrade, in particular, under the
leadership of the secretary, we will have a major publicity campaign to let the public what is on offer on ERB. So we are enhancing publicity in on TV and also radio to attract more trainees. And as for the young people, we're going to enhance publicity in schools. Schools are where the university admission rate is not so high, so that our students know that there is an option between going to work or starting to work or further their studies. They can enroll a short-term course to understand their interest. We'll also have trial programs and practical programs to attract young people. And as for the Smart Living Regional Service or Smart Living Scheme, we have seen challenges in the past few years. In fact, we have a bigger market, because for domestic helpers and confinement ladies, after we have built up this market, there is competition from the private sector as well. We welcome that. Now we try to help those who have just completed training with no experience in as confinement ladies and domestic helpers to acquire jobs. So if people employ our newly trained staff, then we have our Smart Living Scheme to offer support. There may be a nurse there to help. So what we are providing is different from our experienced domestic helpers are providing. For instance, every year we have a year-end cleaning services. Chief Executive Director, can you give us a more detailed report so that we can understand how you are going to implement recommendations by the Audit Commission? We're going to follow up until all recommendations are implemented. Then we can close the file. Thank you very much for coming to the meeting today. This is the first time we have this approach. I don't think the secretary would want us to have a supplementary public hearing. So we just want to highlight the problems you face, and you tell us your plan on improvement. And please give us a supplementary paper on questions we've asked. Thank you.